Hello you guys! Today I'm going to be introducing you to all the products that I used for this nail art design. It's really easy, it's really fun, it's really simple, and yet fancy. You can use it to school, you can use it to fancy parties, I don't know, you can use it for anything. Okay, let's get started. I used, for the base coat, this color. It is NYX, and it is... not sure. I don't know, this is what the numbers look like, though. You can see it. Whatever, it was the purple. You can use any color, it really doesn't matter. It's your choice. These are just my colors of choice today. So that's pretty much it. I used this kleancolor polish, and it is called Stary Purple. It is number 35. I also used a simple top coat, and I used acrylic paints. These are 59 cents at Michael's, so you guys can go ahead and buy them. They're really, really cheap. And these guys will be using as well. These are what their tips look like. I don't have a brand for them. They are like no brand. Just make sure that they look like this and it'll work just fine. I'm fed up with finding brushes that don't work, and I went to the swap meet and bought these. So these worked really fine. Well, actually they came in a pack, but you get what I'm saying. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. I hope you guys like this design. I'm not quite finished with this hand because I don't get around to it. Yes, I hope you guys enjoy it. Have fun, and I will see you right now when my video comes in.
Yeah, what's up, girl? I already told you I'm asking, you know what I mean? Girl fucking with you. Hey, I know. Sorry, and it's that and all that, you know, it's all good. Don't even trip. I ain't sweating you. You know what I mean? Do your thing, girl. I'm gonna do mine.
What's up, little bitch? I know you want me back. I seen you staring at my pictures of all my old hood rats. And I laugh that you never knew I had it like that. Kicking back with a top-notch bitch on my lap. It was funny the way you like to play your little games. With the stomps, it's a G, so you could save it for them lame. Thought I trip over you, bitch, that's why you did what you did. But you could never play the player, cause those tricks is for kids. I tried to be a good apostle to a hyena like you, but you could never keep it true, that's why I gave you the boot. Now tell me why you acted shy when I was spitting my game. Looked in my eyes and told me lies, now this shit ain't the same. I show respect and never let you when the homies recall. And when the hood rats try to call, disconnected them all. But now you're tripping on the things that haters say about me. They said I wasn't worth your time and I was trying to creep. And so you started acting strange and playing a stupid ass game. Said I wasn't worth the trouble and that I would never change. But I still gave you the key to my heart and my soul. You would lie about the motherfucking places you go. And so I try to let you know how I was feeling about you. I kept it true and never tripped on all the things that you do. But then it clicked up in my head that you were up to no good. Cause I would hear about the places you were seen in the hood. And when I hit you up about the places you be, you try to hide the truth instead of being honest with me. That's when I had about enough of all the drama and snap. You wanted to play me like a fool, that's why your ass got slapped. And now you're on your own, girl, that's how I handle my shit. Now you wish you were back home so I could give you this dick. It's all a joke now, baby, cause I'm out on the prowl. I got hyenas on my dick in every state and every town. Now I got it going on with this gangsta rap. And you're still playing your games, running around with the trap. You wanna come back home to me cause you never had it so good. But it's too late now, girl, cause I'm back in the hood. I'm getting paid, getting laid, and I don't ever trip. I'm taking trips state to state, got money to flip. You try to diss this, baby, now you miss this. Maybe you should try to keep it real instead of acting so shady.
Shady ass bitch. No, it was a trip. Used to have them talks and, you know, I tell you how I was, how I felt about you, and, you know, you were telling me how you was gonna change, and, you know, that you wanted to settle down, and, you know, you glad you found a good boss on, and whoop-de-whoop, yeah, you know, it sounds good, girl, but.
College graduate wouldn't even stop to talk to the average kid. The type of Latina I'd sit and contemplate marriage with. Fuck the horse and carriage shit. Her love was never for hire. Disciplined, intellectual beauty's what I desire. Flyer than Selma Hayek or Jennifer Lopez. Everyone told me kicking it to her was hopeless. At first I just thought she didn't mess with broke kids. A thug niggas always talking about how they smoke kids. But the rich sniff coke kids got no play. I'm not even interested in what her body language would say. Everyone around the way gave up trying to get in it. Cause didn't matter how good your game was, she wasn't with it. All the block bitches was jealous but wouldn't admit it. Talk shit and deny to everyone that they did it. Cause they regretted the long list of niggas that they let hit it. And no one ever gave them shit except McDonald's and did it. Smoking weed with thoughts of envy whenever they lit it. She spoke intelligently and they bit it, always trying to copy. But when they tried to use her vocab, they sounded sloppy. She had a style all her own, respectful and pure. I was sick in the head for her and there wasn't a cure. Brown and beautiful, yet empty and sad. I used to talk to her occasionally and she was glad that I wasn't just another nigga trying to get in it. So every now and then we'd stop and talk for a minute. I didn't have a gimmick, so the minutes turned to hours. On her birthday, I gave her a poem with flowers. Then I took her out to dinner after her cousin's baby shower. We talked about power to the people and such. We spent more time together, but it was never enough. I never tried to sneak a touch or even cop a feel. I was too interested in keeping it real. Perfectly honest and complete, she would always call me cariño. And never technique, bought me a new book to read every 2 or 3 weeks.